Welcome back. The Detroit Red Wings with the 4-3 lead after the first period. That'll send you to do some strange things, won't it? Draper's the one who made it 3-1 as every chance given by the Kings resulted in a goal to the back of the net by Detroit. More action coming up from Detroit. Second period, Red Wings 4 and the Kings 3.
The Stanley Cup playoffs on ABC, brought to you by MasterCard, official card of the NHL and fan of the toughest players on the planet. Budweiser, the beer with the fresh, clean taste that's never filling. Eagle One Car Appearance Products for the look you dream about. And IBM, are you ready for e-business?
Martin Lapointe had 2 goals. Robitaille, a goal and 2 assists. Blake, 2 assists and an explosive first period, 4-3 Wings.
You know, Andy Murray, the head coach for the Kings, knows that he needs everything going his way. And his family is in Faribault, Minnesota, where he coached at Shattuck St. Mary's Prep last year. His wife, Ruth, and 3 kids. And his young son, Jordy, who just turned 10, decided that he wanted to help dad beat the Detroit Red Wings. So this is one of the cute moments, folks, in sports. Last week, this is what Jordy faxed to dad, some diagrams of plays to run in practice so that Scotty Bowman could, in fact, be defeated. And Love Jordy was how he signed it. And Andy Murray appropriately said, Scotty Bowman is in trouble now. Way to go, Jordy.
That is the Vince Lombardi School of Hockey right there, sending that tight end in deep, Scotty. That's why he has that look on his face. He saw that during the intermission and said, uh-oh, Jordy's involved. I am in trouble now.
Well, I tell you what, Andy Murray did a heck of a job of coaching in the first period.
He did. He kept it tight, let his goaltender in and out of there. Regroup, Stephane Fissé. First game, backhander, save made, Fissé. Martin Lapointe, centering pass, knocked away Bobby Corker. In the first game, Los Angeles had 19 total shots. In the first period of this game, 21. 21 to 15, the shots in favor of the Kings. Almost a game's worth on average for Detroit. I mean, that's just unbelievable. And you know Scotty Bowman is not happy about this because he believes in playoff defense winning games.
Gary, noticeably, the Detroit Red Wings had everything come easy to them, and the play ended up being spread out. That is not a good defensive posture to take on the edge. Way too much room for the LA Kings for Scotty Bowman's liking.
And we're going to get a penalty on the Kings right here on the touch-up. A tripping call. So, only took a very short time to go back to the specialty teams here in the second period.
Minor tripping.
Tripping call will put Detroit on the power play to start the period, and Blake is gone.
And the tower of power on the penalty kill is the man that it will be in the box. There was the chop and the subsequent takedown of Chris Draper. So really the most valuable penalty killer that the LA Kings have will have to sit and watch this one.
In case you're wondering, most goals teams combined in a playoff period is 9. Done twice, Rangers Philadelphia 79, LA Calgary in 90. So the teams did not break that mark either. 0-for-2 in the power play, the Kings. 1-for-2 for the Red Wings. The power play goal was Lapointe's. This will be power play number 3. Steve Yzerman, the captain, out there in the power play unit. Third power play of the game for the Detroit Red Wings. Back it comes to Fedorov. Fedorov, a chance, blasted wide. Fissé never saw that. Lidstrom will hold it in. Nicky Lidstrom, most ice time in the first 9:47 of any player on either team. Yzerman working a point. Leaves it. He looked down low for Fedorov, had it blocked. Lidstrom in. And around Murray, dropped it center. And not deflected. Rebound shot, Yzerman, that one. Cook Smolenski off the skate, he's cleared up.
Interesting start to this power play for Detroit. Steve Yzerman really strong on his backhand pull in the faceoff, so he took the draw and then switched with Sergei Fedorov once he had won the draw and went back to the point position.
Now Blake, 4 shots. Robitaille, 4. 4 for Shanahan. They were the leaders in shots on in the period. Third around, not out of the zone. Carlotti did not get it out of there. Yzerman plays a point on this first power play unit. Even though he is a forward, something you see more of in the NHL. There's only one D out there, and that's him, Lidstrom. And that's deflected by Tomas Hellstrom. Right into the crease. Still loose. Cleared to the boards, a big pileup in front. Lidstrom, Fedorov, one-timer. Blocked behind the net by Fissé. Bobby Corkum will gain a little breathing room.
Tell you what, Pat Verbeek just spent I imagine 10 or 12 of the most thrilling seconds of his career in front in the trenches. Boy, did he get beat up.
It is a battle royal in front of each netminder. Both teams wanting to charge the opponent's goaltender and create confusion down low. Martin Lapointe sent that one in. O'Donnell didn't get it out of there. Shanahan. Shanahan with 28 on the power play. Got it back. Tried to jam it in and couldn't. Desai held the net. Shanahan has become one of the Gretzkyites since Wayne has left. In bouncing or trying to bounce the puck off the back of goaltenders and into the net. Gretzky made a habit of doing that and really kind of created that play. Shanahan has picked up on that. We've seen him do it a couple times this year. Larry Murphy. Murphy will send it in. Second power play unit out. Martin Lapointe. Shanahan. Duchesne at a point. Off the boards. Played by Lariano. Wide open Steve Duchesne. Save made for Say. And cleared out of the zone. That one was blocked by a Red Wing. And he's hurt. Into the middle. Palfy. Palfy had a man open. He had Stoffel cutting. 5-on-5. Penalty is over. Shanahan up ice. Shanahan taking away O'Donnell. Detroit was changing. They got a 3-on-1. O'Donnell. Trying to center. Held it too long. John O'Donnell. Once, twice. Tried to go into the middle. And Duchesne blocked it both times. And then to control the puck. Great play by Steve Duchesne at the other end. Draper.
It is incredible the number of times a team will have a golden scoring opportunity at one end that will bog down. And the other team will come back and just drive it into the twine the way Chris Draper did. Sean O'Donnell on the 3-on-1 waited too long, Gary, as you pointed out. And when the puck finally got over to Chris Draper, who has absolutely got rockets in his skates today, he is flying for the Red Wings. One of the great role players for Detroit has given him a 5-3 lead. Jamie Storr is coming on. I'm not going on record as to whether or not this is a permanent change or not. There's Chris Draper and the subsequent counterattack by Detroit. He just lasered that one by Fizet. Watch Fizet. He is out top. He's out of the crease, cutting down the angles, got everything taken care of. Can't tell you how much room he left on the short side, but that's where Draper shot. And I'm not sure if he's able to position himself any better. That was a laser.
5 goals during the regular season for Draper. He's added 2 here in this one. It is a 5-3 lead, and for the second time, Stefan Fisse goes to the bench. He went out in the first period at 6:56, came right back in at 7:27 on the next whistle. He goes out here at 3:27 of the second period, and Jamie Storr is back in net for the second time. Backed up by Chris Chelios. Monty couldn't get it. Ron Blake a chance. That deflected right along the blue line. Osgood came back and a whistle on the offside. My oh my. Let's check in John Davidson and John Saunders.
Well, guys, another question from abcsports.com or nhl.com. Are the Wings a little too old?
No, absolutely not. I mean, it didn't bother Dallas last year, and they had some older players on their team. No, I think Detroit, they're older players like Larionov and Chelios right here, Yzerman right here. They're very, very smart people. In fact, I think Billy Clement could probably still play.
Hey, Billy, you hear that? Get your stick out. Get your skates out of storage.
There you go.
Can't tell you how much I appreciate that, guys, but if you knew how wrong you were, I'll tell you what. If you felt like I did when I go to bed in the morning, you would know that I have no chance, guys.
The key to that is that you go to bed in the morning. That may be one of the reasons you feel that way.
Better off. Better off moves it into the zone. Kozlov! Jamie Storr! Welcome to the game! He did not have to make a save when he came out for a few seconds in that first period, but he had to make one there.
No, he may have to make more because Stefan Fizet is actually sitting down with his mask off and his gloves off watching Sergei Fedorov. When he starts to serpentine, you got a problem. Nobody winds his way through traffic better than Sergei Fedorov in this entire sport. Some guys might be a little faster, some guys might do a couple things better, but nobody can snake his way through traffic better than Sergei Fedorov.
A great tool player. He's got them all. Speed, power, back checks, forechecks, and can hit. He is one of the game's great stars. Jamie Storr played 31 seconds in the first period. He's in there now in the second. So 5 goals scored against Stefan Fisse in this game. A on 17 shots by Detroit. Kozlov in his own end. Dumped it around the near side. 3:27. Time of the goal by Draper. His second of the game. That one deflected off bodies in front and cleared back out. Duchesne got the only assist on Detroit's fifth goal. Rolled in wide. We've seen the Kings come back here in this game. Every time Detroit looks as though they're going to run away with it, Kings have been able to find a goal.
But I still don't see Detroit back checking the way they do when the game is close. I see more space out there for Los Angeles. I think the Kings, if they just stick with it, can get back into it again.
Detroit's not doing what the game plan is. That tight checking game, cutting down space and time against the Kings, hasn't happened here. They've been willing to go into more of a run and gun game, and that is not the game plan for the Detroit Red Wings. Cleared back into the middle of Robitaille. Robitaille, Palfy picking up goals. Fireside, stumbled, got tied up, net taken away. Cleared up to Pat Verbeek. Another good defensive play by Steve Duchesne. He's having a game. That one, Jamie Storr, to kick that one out. Deflected back in behind the net. Pat Verbeek wound up and got a good shot off on Storr that time. Dumped past Verbeek in the middle. Tried to turn it. Eisenman. Eisenman looking. Gilchrist in front of the net. Left it. Duchesne. Deflected wide. Gilchrist was trying to redirect. Cleared out by Robitaille. Detroit changing behind the play. Palfy had it taken away. Duchesne left it in the middle. Kings need a change and don't get it. Larionov. Wide side Shanahan. Shanahan. That deflected by Blake in front. Robitaille can't handle it. In the corner, Blake doing battle. Back up to Chelios on the tip pass. Gill the shot. That one deflected again. Kozlov in front of the net waiting for a chance. Look at the move right there by Gill. Polchek to Chelios. His shot. Storr the save. This is a shooting gallery right now. Blake moves it to the red and will dump it in. Osgood holds it out. Both teams over the boards. 5-3. Detroit leading it. Trying to take a 2-0 lead in this series. Entirely different games. A 2-0 first game shutout for Osgood, including an empty netter. This one exactly the opposite. O'Donnell dumped it in. Kelly Buchberger giving chase. Beaten to it. O'Donnell will hold it in. As Maltby couldn't clear it. Osgood the save.
Well, when a coach makes a goaltending change, we're a little bit of scrum here in front of Chris Osgood. Nothing serious. Who wants to go to the penalty box? Nobody. When a coach makes a goaltending change, he doesn't get a chance to warm his guy up that he's sending in. That was the case for Jamie Storr moments ago, and he had to make a super save on Chris Chelios, even though he might have been cold.
I don't think there's anybody who anticipated this game two would look like this, Bill. A wide open offensive game.
You didn't?
I didn't. I swear.
I didn't either, man. I'll tell you what, this is why no lead is safe. As soon as the game opens up and it becomes run and gun, it becomes just a goaltender's duel that's wide open. And if you get the better goaltending, which is the case, I guess, even in low scoring games, but when it's this wide open, it becomes very unpredictable, and that is why no lead is safe.
It is an unpredictable game here. Larry Murphy from Lidstrom. Martin LaPointe on the near side wall. Waited, couldn't get it. Look at the pass. All alone. 1-0. And a save made by Jamie Storr. What a chance. Draper, who's had a big day already, went in all by his lonesome. And this game continues with the same mode of play.
Gary, Kurt Maltby could have gone in with him on a 2-on-0, but he hung back to try to do a little blocking to make sure that Draper went in with nobody tugging at him from behind. So Chris Draper was solo, looking for the hat trick. Larry Murphy, know what John Davidson said? Doesn't matter how old these guys are, they're smart. It's what he was talking about. Larry Murphy with that long lead pass. What if it was over seven lines? Oh man, Jamie Storr just got a chunk of that with his blocker, little plywood glove. And it went down and dropped in front of him, but Larry Murphy sees the ice so well. Very hard to line up and to punish physically, even though he's not that fast. That tells you what? Really smart.
Larry Murphy makes a habit of being in the playoffs. For Murphy, the 17th consecutive year. He's been in the playoffs going back to 1984. A veteran with a lot of smarts. Out through center, Holmstrom took the hit. Third back up the wall. McCarty had also taken a run from Corkum and lost his helmet. O'Donnell in behind the net. Drops that one off. 12:51 to go. We are in period number two, a 5-3 game. And Osgood deflects the Galley chance. Near side, Gary Galley after his own rebound. Corkum came up to help out. Penalty coming up. Delayed call. No whistle yet. Going to be on the Kings. Detroit Holmstrom drops it off. Osgood waiting in net. Not going to leave here. Left puck comes up through center. He's not going to leave at all.
He doesn't know.
Osgood. Fans are kind of hollering for him to go to the bench, get the extra skater. He didn't realize the call had been made because Carey Fraser made it, and he was way back at center ice with the arm up. And Osgood couldn't see him. Let's get the call.
Number 9, Los Angeles. 2 minutes charging.
Another power play. A reminder coming up Sunday night, tomorrow, ESPN2 at 7:30. The Philadelphia Flyers and the Buffalo Sabres. Oh, my. Game 3 with Philly leading 2-0. And after last night with the goal that wasn't, ESPN ABC exclusive networks for the Stanley Cup. And I'm sorry, but I got to say, you got to get it right. And the league didn't get it right last night, and that was wrong.
Yes, we have to get it right. And I also feel the pain of the folks in Buffalo. There's the charge by Kelly Bookberger that puts the Red Wings back in the power play. Now, I said no lead is safe. That save Jamie Storm made on Chris Draper kept this a two-goal disadvantage for the LA Kings. He's going to have to come up big here on this penalty kill. If Draper gets that one, a three-goal lead, well, maybe I exaggerated by saying no lead is safe. I would bet heavily on Detroit if they took a three-goal lead.
Yeah, absolutely. Bookberger, 7:36, penalty, fourth power play of the game. The Detroit Red Wings have scored a power play goal with the best power play unit during the NHL's regular season. They are now 1-for-9 here in the first round of the playoffs against the Kings. Storr played it up, not up. Verbeek held it in. Tried to dump it into the corner, intercepted once, twice on the clear by Norsgaard. Lidstrom will chase it down. Near side to Duchesne. Duchesne, another great pass. Yzerman. Yzerman looking. He'll play a point. Lidstrom a shot. Blocked out deep. Shanahan a shot. Blocked out deep and clear.
Boy,
put your body down.
Way to give it up for the team. Dan Bylsma on the first one and then Rob Blake on the second one.
Two bodies down in front of those shots. Both players let the puck go into the pads and they're all right. Duchesne sent it in for Bibik. Shanahan. O'Donnell had lost it. In the middle shot. Storr looked behind him, but Bibik will be denied. My, oh, my, oh, my. 55 left on the power play. Let's take a look at our Bud Light Stanley Cup Sunday. The Penguins, only lower seed to win a game one. The Kings, 9 consecutive playoff game losses. And on this date, Alex Shebecki, New York Rangers, first penalty shot in finals history. Detroit rookie Earl Robertson stopped him. The Red Wings went on to win their second straight cup.
Pat Verbeek was trying to find daylight here. Gary Galley with a great job to extend and whack Verbeek's stick as he was getting rid of it. He didn't get all the mustard on it that he wanted, and Jamie Storr was able to eat it up.
53 left on the power play. Kings win the draw, cleared out. Advantage in faceoff first period. 57% went to Detroit in the first game. The draws were in favor of Los Angeles. 36-31 overall in the game. Power play with Fedorov on it. Fedorov open. He'll take it. That's blocked right back to it. Leaves it over to Larry Murphy. Big hack put on by Bylsma. Blocked that last shot. Bylsma, great penalty killing effort here. 25 left on the power play. Murphy off shooting wing for him. Leaves it on top. Chelios saved. Rebound. Fedorov couldn't get a shot up. Rebound shot. Lapointe loose. Still loose. Lapointe reaching. Lapointe tied up. Fedorov shot and he missed the net. Rebound. Up. Larry Murphy holds. It along the blue. Murphy held it in. Dropped the shot. Score! What a play by Larry Murphy to hold that puck in. And Martin Lapointe. 6-3.
You want to see smarts? Check this replay out. Larry Murphy with an incredible keep at the blue line. Couldn't see it because it was against the near boards, but I'll guarantee you it was close. It was within a hair. It bounced over Murphy's stick. He got it, ooh, just before it came out. And that quickly, he found Marty Lapointe. You had to know that he could sense where Lapointe was going to be. And he dished off a perfect one-time pass. And we've got octopus sushi on the table right here at the Joe. What a great pass. I mean, not only did he have to get rid of it so quickly, but he had to put it right into the wheelhouse of Lapointe so that he could one-time it. When the pass is that long, the goalie has a chance to adjust. but LaPointe got rid of it so quickly because the pass was perfect that Jamie Storr missed it.
First career hat trick, Martin LaPointe, and they've got to clear the ice. Let's check in with Brian Engblom. Brian.
Gary, Larry Murphy is such a smart defenseman. I talked to him a couple of days ago, and he was talking about his play with Nicholas Lidstrom in particular. Both these guys are so super intelligent. He said, if you watch us play together as compared to when I have a different partner, we are much more territorial. We stay on our own side of the ice. Therefore, there are more exchanges of assignments as the other players start to crisscross in front. That takes a lot of brains and a lot of talent. It's just one of the many things that Larry Murphy can do well.
Yep, and you know, Larry Murphy was traded for a pretty smart player once. That would be Brian Engblom.
That'd be Brian Engblom, double the good D. So Murphy sets it up, LaPointe gets his first career playoff hat trick, and it is a 6-3 lead for the Detroit Red Wings as they put it by Jamie Storr and gives it up first against him. Goal coming at 9:33, LaPointe for Murphy and Fedorov. Two power play goals in the game, 2-for-4 on the power play for Detroit here in game two. Played by Dandino. Dandino around with 5:52 left to go in the second period. 26-23 the shots now in favor of Detroit. Only a couple of shots here in this period for the Kings, as Detroit has knuckled down. Even though the game's open, shots have not been there for L.A. Robitaille got the up to the red, dumped it back into the middle. Brock pass, no dice there. They're back up and out of the zone by Gill.
Los Angeles has to go back and remember how they scored in this game. Get the puck deep, crowd the front, pay the price, get into the trenches and score them ugly.
Stumpel's pass will be intercepted. Detroit just flying. Look at these guys flying here. Look at the shots, 12-2. In the second period, McCarty, score knocked it down. Tried to clear it out, shot it right into Maltby. But it bounced in the air and came to the near side. Stumpel, he'll move it in. Dropped it off for Galley. Nope, Stumpel trying to get it back from Palfy. Palfy paid the price, Stumpel pays the price. Two hits. Here's Palfy on the near side. Only one D back, sent it in. Osgood deflected that, holding the short side. Larry Murphy back out on the ice.
What a hit by Chris Draper. He had locked up the left wing. Three Red Wings were backing up, and Stumpel paid a price. Joseph Stumpel is going to have to continue to pay that price to get L.A. back into the game. He is their big puck-carrying guy that can really get it done down low and set up Palfy and Robitaille.
And Detroit knows that, so obviously they are on him. Gilchrist on the far side. Eisenman moved in. Eisenman, Gilchrist, and Verbeek on this line. Back to Blake. His chance. Osgood to save. Rebound Murphy. Lost it. Greg Johnson. Score!
Amazing. It is almost as if the hockey gods give it and they take it away. After Larry Murphy made so many good plays that we were able to show everybody in this game, he goes to the bench shaking his head because he knows what he has done here. Rob Blake, the shot, trying to get traffic. Watch what Murphy does here. He tries to scoot it back to Chris Osgood. And Craig Johnson, with a real timely push of Steve Duchesne, 23 in the purple, 28 in white. He just pushed him down and left himself wide open. But here's Larry Murphy. The puck is right there. What he's going to try and do is just slip it back here to Chris Osgood. But watch Steve Duchesne here get cleared out. Murphy tries to hit him back. Craig Johnson with a real timely push on Steve Duchesne. Otherwise, he doesn't get this goal.
Unbelievable. A game that will not go to either camp. 11:43, the time of the goal. Johnson gets his first of the playoff year, second of his playoff career, to make it a two-goal game. Greg Johnson over Osgood is going, oh, my. Game still to be decided despite 6 Red Wing goals. Our Dodge intermission report upcoming. JD's ABCs of Hockey, Penguins, Caps, Sharks, Blues. Highlights coming up for you. 7:58 to go to that intermission.
I think this game qualifies as the second most bizarre in the playoffs already. That 7-0 opening game of Washington-Pittsburgh was even more bizarre. Let's check in with John Saunders.
Here on the Dodge update, Gary and Bill, Phoenix against Colorado. Two-man advantage, and you want to see a pretty fast watch Forsberg. When he gets the puck back, spots Hayduke between the skates and the defender. Picture perfect pass. 3-1, all on the power play. Gary and Bill.
Well, the big word spoken there, Peter Forsberg.
And guess what? He was instrumental in that offensive play. If he gets his game back, they got Sandis Oslund back on board with a two-goal effort in game one. That means all pistons are firing, all systems are going or go for Colorado, and they are a force.
7:52 to go in this one. Detroit trying to take the 2-0 lead in this series against the Kings. And a little pushing and shoving going on with Jason Blake and Kozlov.
That's it. Andy Murray wants him to agitate.
He is. Charges right in. Kozlov slashed at him. Blake came away with a puck, though. Blake in the offensive zone. Back into the corner. Ian LaPerriere. Blake and Chartrand. Checking line out there. Up the near side wall. Martin LaPointe lost it. Kozlov clears it out. 1D back, and that is Blake. The captain will take it back in his own end. 6-4. 27-26 the shots in favor of the Wings. Late offside call here, and that'll bring the faceoff to center.
And if this isn't offside, Marty LaPointe was going to be the real lucky recipient of a good play, a result of a good play that he made. Watch this. Matty Nordstrom had the puck. He took the hit there. Bang. Nordstrom went down, and as LaPointe came back, the puck came to him. Fortunately for the LA Kings, this is why you hit. He took his man out of the play, turned around, got the puck, but it was offside. It's not offside. He pivots and gets a scoring chance.
Martin LaPointe, a huge game already. We're only halfway through. Chris Chelios on the near side. Kept away by LaPointe. Fedorov dumped it into the corner. Nordstrom on him, put the hit on. Kozlov leaves it. LaPointe going for four. Had that one blocked. Modric clears it up. Robitaille got it into the middle. Robitaille will be a trailer here. Palfy looking for him. They've got the three scorers back on the line. There's LaPointe again. Palfy finds his stick after he finds his consciousness. Robitaille centered right over Osgood's stick. Delayed call. Let's see if it's on LaPointe. Going to be an interesting call. LaPointe being held by O'Donnell now as he heads to the bench, and a little nose to nose.
Look at Marty LaPointe, though, dishing up the chin, arms at his side, hoping that O'Donnell will take a poke at him. It is that kind of sacrifice that you make this time of year. Yaroslav Modrý gone to the box. The hitting's picked up too, boy. Marty, look at that. That was a cartwheel by Ziggy Palfy. Palfy's just a little guy. He usually sees those kind of hits coming.
LaPointe with a big smile and congratulations from his teammates. That's his style of play.
From Darren McCarty saying, way to go, bud. That's what you got to play. This great scoring chance here did not sound like it hit the post. There's LaPointe's shot. Watch this. It hits the handle of Jamie Storr's stick. Otherwise, Marty LaPointe's got a trick.
Man, oh, man. So it is still a 6-4, but a power play again for the Wings. Nice sticking on Modrý.
When Marty LaPointe, so far in the playoffs, I know the playoffs are young, has been an absolute force, not only with the hits like that on Palfy, but offensively.
207 hits during the regular season for Martin LaPointe, led the team in that department. Fifth power play of the game now, and Detroit with a chance to up that lead to 3 goals again. Lidstrom deep in the zone in. Took the hit from Glenn Murray, but got the puck away. Off for beat, there's Murray on the penalty kill. Murray and Osgood to knock it down. Los Angeles had only 4 shorthanded goals during the regular season. Detroit gave up only 6. Yzerman kicked it to the stick. Yzerman goes behind the net with it. Lidstrom plays back, waiting for Yzerman to join him right there. Steve Yzerman, power play, big pile up in front. Tomas Holmstrom, Lidstrom to Holmstrom, deflected away and a penalty coming down low. Cleared out of there, Fedorov, Yzerman the touch, and Detroit's going to lose 1:05 worth of power play time. An interference call in front of the net. Tomas Holmstrom, I believe.
96 white interference with the goaltender.
He backed in too far.
Well, that's the double-edged sword, too, that the blockers and jammers, the risk they run in front. Holmstrom is really, really good at getting in front and taking away a goaltender's vision. Get a little too close, and all of a sudden you're going to get called for it. And Holmstrom is somewhere in this picture, but I can't find him. Or corner here somewhere on the right. Yeah, there he is. That's Holmstrom coming in from the right. And that he sets up in front. Oh, well, there. You see why he might have done something to Jamie Storr. He was getting the stick up between the legs and the groin before that. But you know what? It looked like Jamie Storr was doing most of the damage there.
Holmstrom went over to the bench and tried to avoid the penalty. You can see why he's upset.
Yeah, I mean, Story was coming up right in the groin, you know, banging him from underneath with the toe of a stick.
So it will cost the Red Wings a minute five worth of power play time. We'll go 4-on-4. 5:56 left to go here in the second period. And a 4-on-4, third time we have had a 4-on-4 in the game with neither team being able to convert on it. Off the faceoff, it will be won back by Larionov. Larionov had an 0-for-12 in game one on faceoffs. Came back in the first period of this game and went 2-for-4. 6-for-10, best faceoff first period, Steve Yzerman for Detroit. Trying to drop that off and down on the ice. Kozlov took a stick to the face. There's no call here. Play goes on. Now the whistle behind the play. Kozlov went down. No whistle, no penalty. They blew the whistle because he was injured. Now the officials will confer and we'll see whether or not any call comes up. 6-4 Wings.
So we'll get back to play. Slava Kozlov went off the ice. He wasn't really hurt, but he did, in fact, our replay show, get hit high. There he is, 13 white. Watch the stick of Sean O'Donnell come up and almost under the visor. Tapped him in the mouth. More look at it. Stick on the left, the stick of O'Donnell's. Boy, it came up and kind of crammed his helmet up. He's all right. Didn't hurt him that bad, but he definitely got hit with a stick in the face.
And no call.
So what do you do in that case? I think that's a pretty good non-call, whether it's accidental or careless, if the player isn't hurt.
Right back up by Chelios. You know I'm one of those. Anything with a stick, at least 4 minutes. Automatic. On the far side, Murray. Murray dropped it in. And Chelios the intercept. Bad pass. Duchesne a chance. Deflected. Jamie Storr reaching out with a blocker. 4-on-4 for another 15 seconds. Into the middle. L.A. trying to get it back to another one-goal game. Murray a chance. That one hit bodies out in front. Power play coming in 5 seconds. For the Kings, Chelios will send that one in deep. And a 55-second power play now for Los Angeles and a whistle. Behind the play, there were a lot of guys on the ice.
Still, they got six out there now, Detroit does.
Count them up, they're still out there. And he is counting them up. Coming across ice, Dennis LaRue kept counting.
Los Angeles, bench minor penalty, too many men on the ice.
Gary Fraser with a call, and that's going to cost the Kings 53 seconds worth of power play time. Andy Murray's not going to be happy with that. Bad line change for L.A.
Detroit's penalty or L.A.'s penalty?
L.A.'s penalty.
Gosh. Detroit had, what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six Red Wings.
They were just trying to even it up. The Kings will be called for too many on the ice.
What's that happen?
Well, they had 7.
That was pretty bad. You're just not allowed to have one more than the other team.
That's right. As long as you keep it even, you're okay.
When I looked and when I realized it was too many men penalty, Detroit distinctly had 6 skaters out there.
Well, back to 4-on-4.
And a goalie.
And a goalie.
Yeah.
Back to 4-on-4, maybe, for some 53 seconds. Osgood comes on the play. This Palfy knocked it down. Murphy picks it up. Larry Murphy with Palfy up on the forecheck here. Played back in behind the net. He'll work from there. Nicky Lidstrom. Lidstrom moving it up. Candidate for the Norris Trophy. Best defenseman in the NHL, Nicky Lidstrom. Murphy takes the hit from Blake. Here's Palfy shorthanded. They've got a 3-on-2. Shorthanded. Blake. Back up short-handed again. Nordstrom drops it. Stumble. That one's blocked. Great chances for the Kings short-handed. Could not convert. Here comes Malby and 4-on-4 rather. And a save by Storr. 4-on-4 chances at each end of the ice.
And lots of ice to work with.
And the LA chance.
The LA Kings had both defensemen jump up on their chance. Then the play came the other way. How bizarre. How bizarre. Larry Murphy, who we said hardly gets hit and hardly ever makes a bad play, gets hit on this one with the worst part of Rob Blake's body. When he gets you with the big rear end like that coming at you, you might as well have been hit by an automobile bumper. And then Ziggy Palfy laid it out perfectly for Rob Blake, but Chris Osgood made a good play on this, but I'm not sure Rob Blake's shot was even on net. I think it might have been going wide.
Norris is a former trophy, Norris Trophy winner right there. Rob Blake, you see the hits. Believe it or not, second on the Kings in the hit department. Nordstrom had more, 260.
So Rob Blake plays so much, he can't go looking for the hits like he used to, and it's not wise. I mean, you've got to hold your position, and to go out of position to make the hit is a mistake, but it's amazing Rob Blake is number two as much as he plays.
Lindstrom and a save made by Jamie Storr. 4 seconds and a power play coming up for the Red Wings. Right now they've got 1:07 worth of power play time. This will be power play number 6. They have scored a couple of power play goals here in this game. 2 for 5 on the power play. A 6-4 lead. Big penalty kill. Again, Yzerman. That's twice he's done that. Kicking it in off his skate onto his stick. Intercepted and cleared out of the zone by Sean O'Donnell. Osgood holding it up the other end. Great to have you with us. NHL and ABC game 2. First round. And the Detroit Red Wings trying to make it 2-0 in the series. Have the 6-4 lead in a wild game. Verbeek sends it back. Tomas Holmstrom protected but couldn't get the puck. Murray trying to clear. Bounced away off Fedorov's stick off the dasher. Off Yzerman's stick. Yzerman controlling that. Murray was ready to break shorthanded. Near side for Tomas Holmstrom. Holmstrom looking along the blue line. Pass deflected off Yzerman. Held in. Fedorov. Fedorov behind the net. Hit by Nordstrom. Fedorov looking for Lidstrom, and they couldn't get it to him. Verbeek, Holmstrom in front, pass off bodies to center.
He was looking for Steve Yzerman. Yzerman had snuck in the back door, but there were just too many skates in the way for Verbeek to get it through.
Both teams change it up here. Blake's got it. Penalty over. 5-on-5. Into the middle. Osgood will knock that one down and hang on with Blake moving in. 2:34 to go. Second period. Furiously paced offensive game. And our Eagle One storyline, Martin LaPointe, first career playoff hat trick. Detroit 4 goals in a matter of 6:01 in that first period.
Well, our Eagle One replays, Detroit scored too many goals to show you in this game. So we'll show you Los Angeles's goals. But the important thing is how they scored them. This to me is how they have to continue to play. Block, jam, get physical, pay a price. Go to the areas of the ice where your heart beats fast. You know you're in traffic and you know you're going to get smoked.
Amazing.
Bodies were flying when Sean O'Donnell scored his. And then Craig Johnson scored the 4th Los Angeles goal. But this is how they have to continue to keep playing the LA Kings.
10 goals combined, a record for total goals in one game, 18. Set LA Edmonton, as you might expect, back in those big days of the Edmonton Oilers. And every game had about 10 goals just for them. Robitaille tipped that one in with a little hook on Chelios and control the puck. Robitaille and Chelios do battle on the boards. Robitaille trying to center. Taken away by Draper, re-stolen Greg Johnson. Set back in to the corner. Grinding battle going on now. And it'll be brought out to Darren McCarty. McCarty leaves it. LaPointe, the Draper, Duchesne rather cutting, couldn't get the backhand pass off. Stumble on the intercept. Brought back up to Palfy. Poke checked away at center. That was McCarty knocking down Robitaille. Shanahan from center ice. Gunned it in so Detroit could change it up. Modry came back to get it. Shanahan, LaPointe, Draper, LaPointe, Draper, LaPointe. Those are the goals for the Detroit Red Wings. They've piled up 6 of them. Backhanders right through the top of the crease. First offensive chance for the checking line. That was Jason Blake who had it. Robitaille, O'Donnell. They have picked up goals in this game for the Los Angeles Kings, and Palfy the 4th. Make it a 6-4 game. Back in behind the net. Slow it down a little bit. Detroit making sure they've got 3 back here now with 1:05 left to go. Osgood knocked it down and shot. Trent trying to run the rebound in. Blake centering pass came all the way back up. The Blake shot. That's deflected. Penalty coming up. Delay call in Detroit. Nordstrom extra skater out. Osgood waiting for the loose puck. Jammed out. Whistle.
This looks more like a rugby scrum than a hockey game right here. Brendan Shanahan is ripping away at Ian LaPerriere's jersey, and LaPerriere is still. I've got plenty of time for dialogue, folks. Don't let this little guy in my back bother me. I think he was talking to Carey Fraser, Denny LaRue, our refs, and talking about the call right away. It was like Brendan Shanahan wasn't even an issue to him.
Now that, ladies and gentlemen, is focus.
Ian LaPerriere picked up just a few fighting majors during the regular season. We won't see many of them in the playoffs, but if there is going to be one, he might get it.
Just 21, right? Led the league.
21.
Uh-huh. Look at Matty Nordstrom here with his hand, with his gloves off, trying to pull Shanahan off LaPerriere. And LaPerriere is paying zero attention to Brendan Shanahan. He was about to get smoked in the chops by Brendan Shanahan, and he could have cared less. That is playoff focus, and I mean that. This is the time of year where you have to ask your players, if you're a coach, how much courage do you have?
2 minutes obstruction.
How much pain are you willing to endure? How high is your pain threshold? That's not LaPerriere that's on the bottom there. That looks like Gary Galley to me.
And Nikki Lidstrom, a Lady Bing candidate.
No, I was wrong. That's Jason Blake. All those guys look alike with their visors on when they're upside down.
It's easy to win the Good Sportsmanship Award when you're the one on top.
Look, I mean, you almost need the jaws of life. There's a pile of guys over on the right there that took about 30 seconds to untangle.
And after all of that, we're going to get an obstruction hooking call.
That's all?
That's all. 51 seconds to go in the period. Price you pay, stitches. Tomorrow. Coming up on ABC, 12 of the top drivers from NASCAR and Indy Racing go head-to-head, identical IROC Pontiac Firebird Trans Ams, the International Race of Champions from Talladega. Tomorrow, 5 Eastern, 2 Pacific on ABC. Well, this wild game continues. 0 for 3 on the power play. They've got 4 shots. Shanahan out of there. Less than a minute to go in the period. Can the Kings do what they did in the first and get a late goal? Osgood gets into a shoving match behind the net.
Would have been calling for a penalty on Osgood. It looked like they kind of just got tangled up and couldn't get apart.
Each gave the other a shove. 13 to go. Galley trying to push it in on the near side wall. Chelios wouldn't let him by. That's deflected away. 6 seconds left to go in the period. And Osgood has to knock that down. Robitaille slapped him. He speared him right in the stomach. Chris Osgood just speared Robitaille on the way by. Took the paddle and drove it right into the midsection of Robitaille.
And I don't think either of the refs saw it.
No call.
Gave him a chop. He definitely chopped him when he was on the way by. And Luke Robitaille said, what was that? And if this game was in L.A., the place would be going crazy.
Our Dodge intermission report is coming up. John Saunders, John Davidson, after this message and a word from our ABC stations.